the spirit of doing it for your country than the Chinese men and women. Based on their past Olympic performances, they have achieved beyond their wildest expectations. The Chinese women's team was comprised of young gymnasts and a veteran, Liu Xuan, back from the Atlanta Games in 1996. She's given every indication that this is it in her Olympic career, and so this would be then the final performance.
And Al, you saw that score, the needs, 9-7-8-8, very possible for her to achieve.
She does a number of elements where she loses sight of the beam, tips her head back, very difficult. Also, big tumbling run right here.
Oh, that was gorgeous.
Here comes one of those elements, right here. Very difficult.
Liu Xuan is wrapping up a career that she believes her mother could have had. She was a top-flight gymnast, but during the Cultural Revolution in China in 1968, the gym was closed down, and the door was closed on that opportunity.
Her mom wanted to travel to Sydney to watch her daughter in probably her final gymnastics competition. Couldn't get a visa, so she's at home watching on television.
One last move.
What a way to go.
Regardless of if she wins a medal here, this has been the most successful Olympic Games for this, both men's and women's Chinese team.
And what a great way for Liu Xuan to end her career. Check out this tumbling pass. What made it so spectacular is she actually tumbles the length of the balance beam but maintains a beautiful laid out position until her feet hit the beam. That was great.
And during that pass, Lin Jia wanted it for her teammate real bad, and after the dismount, they were exuberant, the men and the women. So what's it going to be? It's going to be a gold goodbye.
I venture to guess not in her wildest dreams.
Liu Xuan takes the gold, Yekaterina Labuznyuk the silver, Yelena Prudinova the bronze.